So I'm going to have to make a new dust hood for this router. It just kicks up too much material when it's cutting. It's not necessarily a bad thing because it means the material is being cleared, but because of the force of the air and the router bit spinning at 33,000 RPM, it does throw it all over the place. So my plan is to kind of make quite a simple shape, a little bit narrower than the one I initially made, which attach onto the side here. There's two tapped holes there, and I'm going to use this silicone hose coupler to keep the dust hood quite small. I'm going to try and fit it at an angle, so I'm going to have to work out a plane along the cylinder, and it just means I can keep it down to a very small profile. It would be interesting to try and utilize the air that's been exhausted out so that it still blows into the tool. So what I might do is also drill some holes or try and channel the air down. I mean, if there's going to be a hood around this plus the flaps or brush, the extraction is going to be drawing air out. Don't really see a problem.
I actually went through several iterations of this design. Initially I was going to cut the hole for the silicone coupler on the pillar drill while the acrylic was held at an angle. Not only did I forget to turn the camera on, but the hole saw left a really terrible cut. On a positive note, the CNC is cutting the plastic quite well and the finish looks very neat. The second attempt had me drill the mounting hole for the adjustable arm in the wrong place, which meant the hole for the router bit was incorrectly aligned. I tried to CNC router this out again, but this really is the sort of machine where you have to get things right the first time. I also became impatient, increasing the feed rate and pass depth, which meant I lost a step during one attempt. If there is a moral to this, it is don't use valuable or limited material when CNCing when you have not finalized your design. However, each time the design slightly evolved and I was eventually left with these two pieces. I drilled, tapped and screwed them together, after which I used a thin solution of liquid solvent cement to brush down the cut edges. This acts in a similar way to heating cut acrylic, slightly glossing and hiding any cut marks. I took the flaps from the original extraction hood and added them to the new one. I later cut each individual roll to half their width, which was a little less than 1 cm, to increase flexibility. The coupler was held into place with hot glue, not really the neatest or most secure way to do this, especially considering not much sticks to silicone. I compressed the coupler a little and once the hot glue cooled, it created a tight friction fit. Finally, I checked the extraction by sliding a board with some debris under the hood, which was all vacuumed up. I then cut a square, checking the size against the original file, updated the steps within the firmware, and recut the same shape. The accuracy is as good as I can hope it to be. You can also click on the information card in the top right corner of the video for a CNC related playlist and link to my website.